Hi everybody, thank you for joining us on Hostech Static website on Amazon S3 course. My name is Usama Al-Masalme. I will be your instructor in this course. I have many IT certifications in system administration, virtualization, and cloud compute. In this course, we will cover and learn most of concepts about Hostech Static website on Amazon S3. But before that, I will give you idea about Amazon AWS and Amazon S3 Simple Storage Service. This course will be supported with good examples and labs, and at the end of this course, you will be able to configure and manage Amazon S3 service to host your static website with very low cost and high speed without any server. You only need to upload your website files to Amazon S3 and S3 will do the rest. Okay, let us go ahead with this course. Thank you and see you in next lecture. What we will cover in this course? We will give you an introduction about Amazon AWS service, what is AWS Cloud, and the services provided by AWS. Also, we will speak about which AWS service will be used on this course. Also, we will give an idea about Amazon S3 service, Simple Storage Service, and the benefit of using S3, and we will do simple lab for creating and upload files to S3 bucket. Then we will check how to use one of the features provided by Amazon S3 that allow us to host a static website, and we will do simple lab for host and static for host a static website by create and bucket and enable static hosting on this bucket. Also, we will learn how to host a static website on Amazon S3 using your own domain like example.com, and how to redirect the traffic from subdomain to domain. Then we will do lab how to configure static website on Amazon S3 using your own domain. Thank you and see you in next lecture. What's Amazon AWS? The AWS Cloud provides a broad set of infrastructure services such as computing, power, storage options, networking, and databases delivered as utility on demand, available in seconds with pay-as-you-go pricing to help business scale and grow. AWS helps you to build solutions and applications with increased flexibility, scalability, and reliability. Amazon provides this services on 42 availability zones with 16 geographic regions around the world. Also, there is many regions and availability zones expected to open in the future. The region refers to the geographic place like Virginia and Canada. Every region consists of two or more availability zones. Availability zone is a complete data center provide AWS services. Amazon AWS services. There is many services provided by Amazon AWS in networking, compute, storage, and database. Like in networking, we have Amazon VPC. Amazon VPC, virtual private cloud allow you to build your private data center. Also in compute, we have Amazon EC2, Elastic Cloud Compute, can use to launch instance or virtual server on the cloud. Also, we have in the storage Amazon S3, Simple Storage Service. In database, we have Amazon RDS Relation Database Service. And there is another many of services provided by Amazon AWS. Amazon AWS service will be used in this course. In this course, we will use some of AWS services to host static website on Amazon S3 like Amazon S3, a simple storage service, is storage for the internet. We will use it to store the files and host the static website. Also, we'll use Amazon Route 53, is a highly available and scalable cloud domain name system DNS web service. It's designing to give developers and business an extremely reliable and cost-effective way to route end users to internet applications. Also, we'll use AWS Identity and Access Management IAM that enable you to securely control access to AWS services and resources for your users, like who can access to my files on S3 bucket. If you have any question, please feel free to ask or move to next lecture. Thank you. Hi everybody. In this lecture, we will speak about Amazon S3 service and main concept related. What's Amazon S3? Amazon S3 is a storage for the internet. It's a simple storage service that offers software developer a high scalable, reliable, and low latency data storage infrastructure at very low cost. Amazon S3 has a simple web service interface that you can use to store and retrieve any amount of data at any time from anywhere on the web. Amazon S3 stores data as objects within buckets, and buckets are the container for objects. Also, you can choose the geographical region where Amazon S3 will store the bucket and its content, like Virginia or Ireland regions. Also, you can control access or set permissions on the bucket objects as well as any metadata, like you can give everyone read permission on all objects on your bucket. Thank you and see you in next lecture. Hi everybody and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we will do a simple lab for working with Amazon AWS S3 console and the S3 buckets. What we need for this lab, we need any computer with system Mac or Windows or Linux even. Also, we need AWS account to begin provisioning resources to host your website. If you don't have AWS account, you can sign up AWS free tier account from this link. Okay, what we will learn in this lab? In this lab, we will learn how to create AWS free tier account. Then start with S3 service and create delete bucket and upload objects to the bucket. Also, we will learn how to create bucket policy that grants everyone S3 get permission, because when we configure a bucket as a website, we must make the objects that you want to save publicly readable. Okay, let us to go to this link for creating AWS free tier account. AWS free tier, the AWS free tier enables you to gain free hands-on experience with AWS platforms, products, and services. Like, they give you 750 hours per month on Amazon EC2 Elastic Cloud Compute service that you can use it to launch your instance or server on the cloud. Also, they give you 5 GB of storage on Amazon S3 service. Also, they give you 750 hours per month on Amazon RDS Relation Database service. And there is many service you can use it free. And this account is free for 1 year. Now, if we need to create AWS Fleet here account, we will go to create an account. Then he will give it will come to us the window for creating account. We will enter our email address that will be used to log into our account. Like we can, I will enter test email, samaws test@hotmail.com. And I will select I am a new user. If you have already account, you can log in direct. Then sign in. Then another one will come to ask you the more details about your name. You will enter here your name. Then you will enter your account, your email address again, and the password 2 times. Then you select create account. Then the next page will ask you more details about you, like the region and the country, our full name. You'll write here the full name, your full name. Also here you will select company account or personal account. We will select personal account, and we will select the place, the our country, like we can select Ireland. Then the address, we can select any address, street, read 121, like an example, and the city, any city, like also here we can choose anything as our country details. The phone number then will select. All this I'm entering only for testing. It's not really real information. He will enter N5F. I think it's. Then we'll accept the AWS customer agreement. Then we'll choose create an account and continue. Security check, it's not correct. We should to enter again NMG8Y8. Now in next page, we'll ask you for credit card or debit card number. You should to put it, because if you use more than the free usage provided by Amazon AWS, you should, they will charge you by this card. You should enter your credit card details here. After you enter the credit card details here, then you will go, they will do verification for your card and your details, and then they will confirm in next page. They will confirm your account by sending an email to your email address that you registered for this account. After we finish creating the account for AWS, we can have full access to AWS resources and use it for free, as they mentioned, for free tier use. After I log into my account, then this the AWS console. They have all the services here. If we go to services, we can go to we can see most of the service of Amazon AWS, like EC2 or S3, the storage service, RDS, VPC. We will go to S3 service, storage service, that will use it to host our static website. Now we log into AWS S3 console. Here we can create or delete or empty buckets or upload the object to our buckets from the console. Like I have already created some of buckets. We can create, if we need to create bucket from the AWS console, I can go to create bucket. Then I will enter the name of the bucket here, and the name should be unique name and not exist in this region. Like I will select any name, Usama test bucket, because if I select name exist, they will tell me the bucket already exists in bucket name. Like if I select test and I select the region, in any region I can select. There is many regions for AWS services, as we mentioned before, and I can select any region to create my bucket in this region. Like I can select Ireland. If I try to create it, they mentioned the request bucket name is not available because it's already taken. Like it's like the domain for names for internet. So I will create another name. Sorry, I will create bucket. I will put any other name should be not exist. And I will select the region with not exist within one region, should be unique within one region. I will select Ireland. I think this name not exist. And I will create my bucket. Then the bucket, it will be created in Ireland region. And here we'll mention the date of create the bucket. Now, if I click on the bucket, then I will be inside the bucket. From here, I can go to the properties for the bucket, permissions or management. Also, I can upload or create folders inside this bucket. Like if I need to create folder inside this bucket, I will go to create folder and I will enter the name of folder, like test folder, and save. Also, I can upload pictures or anything, any objects to my bucket. I will go to upload, then I will select add files. I will select my object from my computer, like I have this image, and I press open, upload. Now, with this picture, it will be uploaded to this bucket. Here, the picture that we uploaded now. Also, we can delete the folder of the object I upload. Like if I upload again, file, and it will be uploaded after some time. Then if I need to delete it, I will select it from here, and I will select delete object or delete objects. I delete all the objects here because it's mentioned all. If I need here, I deleted objects because I deleted before this. If I need to delete any object. Also, if I need to, here we can delete the object and delete, then it will be deleted from here. Also, I can copy or rename the object to any name or get the size of the object, like rename it to static and save. If we need, now if I need to check the URL for this image, I select the image, then I can see here the URL or the link for this image. But this image or any object, when I upload any object to the S3 bucket, it will be private, not public readable. If I try to open this link, then it will be, you are access denied, I can't see the object of this image. If I need to give permission to see this object, I should give permission for only this image, or for our use for static website, we should give permission for full the bucket of that store the content of the static website. So I should to give something called, as we mentioned before, bucket policy. For that, I will go inside my bucket, then I will go to permissions, then there is something called bucket policy. I will select the bucket policy, then I will write my bucket policy here. And there is a simple way to generate your bucket policy by going to policy generator. Here you can generate your policy to give permission for accessing to S3 bucket. Like then from here, I will select the policy for what it will be for S3 bucket policy. Then what I will select, allow or deny, I will select allow, principal, for whom you will give this permission, for anybody. So I will put enter star. Then I will select the action to give permission, read permission for everyone to read your static website, which should give everyone get object permission. So I will select from here the permission. You can select multi a permission. For me, I will select get object permission. Then we can read the object inside our bucket. Here we will choose Amazon resource name. Amazon resource name, unique name for AWS resources. Like if we have S3, there is something called S3 bucket. There's something called Amazon resource name, ARN. This identifier for this bucket, then we can apply on this bucket any permission or anything. So the ARN will be like this, but only will put here the name of the bucket that will apply the permission on it. So I will select here this format, then I will enter here instead of this my bucket name. Here my bucket name, it was as we did it here, Usama test bucket. So I will enter bucket name here, and after that we will apply for all objects inside this bucket. So I will put the star to apply the policy for all objects inside my bucket. Then I will add a statement. After that, we can generate the policy. This is the policy we should to add it for our bucket. Then everybody can has read permission on all objects in my bucket. So I will copy this policy, then I will go to permission, the bucket policy. I will paste it here. As you see here the name is ID for this policy. Then there is for we give permission action S3 get object effect allow on resource AWS S3 Osama test bucket and any object inside this bucket. So we put star for anybody. So we put also star. We can here decide if we need specific account or specific user to have access for this bucket. After that, we will save the change. After we save the change, we will go to object. Now, if I open the object from the link, should be readable, and the object, the picture should be opened. As we see here, the picture, because now I give everybody read permission, so anybody can open this picture or any picture in my bucket. Now I go back to my bucket. If I, also I can delete full or empty full bucket. Like I will select the bucket from here. I can empty the bucket, then all the objects inside my bucket will be deleted. Or I can delete whole the bucket by select the bucket, then delete bucket. Then will ask me to be sure. Are you sure to delete the bucket? I should to confirm that by writing my bucket name here, then confirm deletion. After that, my bucket will be removed. This our lab, what we learn, in this lab we learn how to create bucket and upload objects to the bucket, delete objects from bucket, how to give permission for anybody or specific user to read or any permission for my objects in my bucket. Also, how to we learn how to delete the bucket. Thank you and see you in next lecture. Hi everybody and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture we will give you some concepts about hosting a static website on S3. You can host a static website on Amazon S3 on a static website individual page web pages include static content, HTML, CSS, images, videos, and other files. They may also contain client-side scripting, like JavaScript. Amazon S3 doesn't support a dynamic website, relies on server-side scripting and processing include server-side scripts such as PHP, GSP, or ASP.NET. To host your static website, you configure an Amazon S3 bucket for website hosting and then upload your website content to the bucket. The website then available at the region-specific website endpoint of the bucket. So, default URL for your static website on S3 will be bucket name that you created, .s3-website, -AWS region, which region you create your bucket, .AmazonAWS.com. This URL returns a default index document that you uploaded and configured for the website. Like example, if you have bucket, if you have a bucket on S3. On Ireland region EU-West-1 called example bucket and we enable static website for this bucket for this S3, then URL will be http example bucket.s3-website-your region. It will be us-est-west-1.amazonaws.com. You can use your own domain instead of processing the website by using an Amazon S3 website endpoint, such as example.com, to serve your content. Amazon S3, in conjunction with Amazon Route 53, supports hosting a website at the root domain. If you use your own domain, the bucket name must match the name of the names of the website that you are hosting. Suppose you need to use your own domain, example.com, to host a static website on Amazon S3. Then you should to create a S3 bucket called example.com and upload your static website content to this bucket. When you configure a S3 bucket as website, you must make the objects that you want to save publicly readable, and you can do this using bucket policy as we see in previous lab. What about monthly billing estimated? The total cost of hosting your static website on AWS will vary depending on your usage. Typically, it will cost $1 to $3 per month if you are outside the AWS free tier limits. If you qualified for AWS free tier and are within the limits, hosting your static website will cost around $0.50 per month. This will be paid for hosting your own domain in the web and the Amazon AWS for Route 53. Of course, if you have too much traffic to your website, then the cost will be more according to the bandwidth that monthly usage and for your website. Thank you and see you in next lecture. In next lecture, we will do a simple lab how to enable a static website for Unbucket. In this lecture, we will do a lab for creating and hosting static website on Amazon S3 and enable host static website on the bucket. Then we will upload our static website to this bucket. Let us start. After you log into your AWS account, Amazon account, then we will go to Amazon's S3 service. Then we'll go to S3 storage service. Then we will create bucket. This bucket will host our files and our website. So I'll go to create bucket. I will enter the name for my bucket here. For I will put any name, nashtree.com. This my bucket name, nashtree.com. This the bucket name, and I will create this bucket in like Ireland region. Then create. After the bucket created, then I will try to upload. I will open the bucket, it will be empty. So I will enable the hosting for or hosting static website for this bucket. First, I will go to upload my files to this bucket. I will go to upload my files for my website, then add files. I create a simple index.html file. This will be as a simple web page. The content is like this. Only simple web page will show welcome world. I can now make this web. That's all. After I upload this to my bucket, I will upload it to my bucket. I will select then open. Then I will upload. Then this file index.html uploaded to my bucket. If I try to open this file, it will be access denied because this not enabled publicly readable for everyone. Now what we will do, first we will enable the S3 host static website from properties. After there is static website hosting, then this is the endpoint for my website. It will be also I will enable use this bucket to host a static website. Then they will ask me where's the index file for my website. So I will give the name. Default will be by default index.html. Here I can give the error page like 404 page when there is any error for opening any page in your website. After that, I will save. Now, if you look here, you'll find the static website hosting enabled for this bucket. Also, we should to give permission for every read permission for everybody on this bucket, nashtheri.com bucket. So what I will go, I'll go to permissions and I will create bucket policy as we see in previous lab. I will go to bucket policy, then I will go to policy generator and I will select my, I will generate the policy from here, star for principal, any account or anybody. Here, I will select for S3 service. So from here, I will select S3 bucket policy and any account or user for S3. What they can do, I will give only permission to get object. Then they can read get object. They can read the files from this bucket. Then here I should to give the Amazon resource name for the my bucket. If I need it, I can go back to my bucket. I'll go to my bucket. If I select my bucket, then I can copy my bucket ARN for this bucket. I press copy, then I'll come back here and enter. Also, I will give this permission for all objects inside my bucket. So I put slash star. Then add statement. Then I will press generate policy. This my policy that this is a policy that I should attach to my bucket. I'll go back to my bucket, then permissions, bucket policy, I will paste the policy here. After that, I will save the change for bucket policy. Now, if I came back to my object, if I open this object, I should be able to read content of this object. I'll go to the object. If I open it again, look, now I can read the content of this object. Okay, now if I need to open my website, as we mentioned before, the website URL for my website URL will be, if I came here and properties to static website hosting, I can find it here, and now it will be the bucket HTTP /my bucket name nashtheri.com, then www.s3-website, then the region name, it will be Ireland region EU-West-1, then .amazonaws.com. If I open this link, then my page should be opened. nashtree.com.s3-website- HTTP. index.html. I put only index.htm, so it should be index.html. I will save again. Now, if I open that link again, it's open. My website now, it's open. And this is the URL for my website. I can, next step, what we will do, we will create our website by our domain, like it will be nashtree.com or www.nashtree.com, not with extension of or subdomain as from Amazon website. Thank you and see you in next lecture. Hi everybody. In this lecture, we will learn how that we'll check the configuration steps for hosting static website using your own domain. First step, we should to register a domain. You can register your domain in Amazon Route 53 or other sites like GoDaddy. Then we should to create and configure buckets to host your site. The bucket's name must match the names of the websites that you are hosting. For example, to host your example.com website on Amazon S3, you could create a bucket named example.com. Like domains, subdomains must have their own Amazon S3 buckets. If you are hosting root domain example.com and have subdomains www.example.com, then we should to create two buckets, first with name example.com. First with name example.com for root domain, and the second one with the second bucket with www.example.com for subdomain. Then upload your website data to example.com bucket. Then the content can be text files, family photos, videos, whatever you want. Also, you should to give the file name of the home page of the website, and it's typically called index.html, but you can give it any name. Configure permission for your objects to make them publicly accessible to everyone. To give read permission, you can write bucket policy that grant everyone S3 get object permission, or make an object publicly readable using an access list and grant read permission to all user group. Configure bucket for website hosting by enable static website hosting from bucket properties. Then we should to create and configure Amazon Route 53 hosted zone. You will configure Amazon Route 53 as your domain name system DNS provider. You must use Amazon Route 53 if you want to save content from your root domain, such as example.com. Last, we should to switch Amazon Route 53 as your DNS provider if you register domain and not in Amazon Route 53. And we should to create an Amazon Route 53 DNS records to add Mabit to our buckets. Thank you and see you in next lecture. Hi everybody and welcome to this lecture. In this lecture, we will do lab for hosting and configuring a static website using your own domain on Amazon S3. First, in this lab, it will be in two parts. First part will be, we will register a domain called nashtari.com, and already I registered one this domain in GoDaddy website. Then we will create hosted zone called nashtari.com and Amazon Route 53, the DNS service on Amazon Web Service. And then we will switch to use Amazon Route 53 as our DNS provider and test our website. Let us to do these three steps, then we'll do the remaining steps. First, you log on your Amazon AWS account. Also, into my account in GoDaddy website, here you can register your domain. After I register my domain, I will go to Amazon Route 53. From Amazon Web Service, I will go to the DNS service for Amazon called Route 53. I will create hosted zone called nashtari.com. Then I will go to hosted zone. I will go to hosted zone, then I will create hosted zone. The name of hosted zone will be nashtari.com, the same name of the domain that I nashtari. Here I can put any comment for this domain, and this domain will be public or private, should be public to be accessible from outside. Then I will create the hosted zone on Amazon Route 53. After I create it, the Amazon will give me the name server for this domain. So I will to switch my domain to be used DNS of Amazon instead of GoDaddy. So I will take this names and I will insert on domain manager. Right, I'll go to my domain configuration, then I will go to manage DNS for my domain, then I will go to down to name servers change. I will check the custom. Then I should to add my name servers here, the four servers that created after I create my hosted zone in Amazon Route 53. I will copy first one and I will paste here, and I will copy the second one. Then I will add also two more name servers, and I will copy the rest of name servers that give me provided from Amazon Route 53. In this step, I'm switching to use Amazon DNS instead of use GoDaddy DNS. After I finish create and paste the name of servers on GoDaddy DNS configuration, I will save. This may be to take effects, maybe it will take some time. Then I will go back to Amazon Route 53. Also, if I need, I can register a domain from Amazon Route 50 by going to Route 50 from services. I will go to Route 53 service. Then I will go after to register domains. Then here, register, I will select register to domain. Then I can here select my domain like test.com. And they will check if available, and I can register in Amazon Route 53 instead of registered in GoDaddy. Thank you. If you have any question, feel free to ask, or see you in part two. Hi, everybody. In this lecture, we'll complete our lab, will be the part two of the lab. First lab, we check how to register and create a hosted zone and switch our DNS service from GoDaddy to Route 50 to use Amazon Route 53 DNS. Now, we will create, in this lab, we will create two buckets, one called nashtri.com for the root domain. Also, we will create www.nashtri.com for the subdomain of nashtri.com. Then I will I already also download a free theme for static website from internet. I will upload this theme to my bucket nashtri.com. Then I will enable redirection for from www.nashtri.com to nashtri.com, because if anybody or any client asks for nashtri.com, then Route 53 will route this request to this bucket. If another one, he asks for subdomain www.nashtri.com, then Amazon Route 53 will route this request to this bucket, and this bucket will redirect the traffic to nashtri.com traffic. So our files will be in nashtri.com bucket and for website, and this only will be empty bucket for only redirect the traffic from subdomain to domain. And always remember, the bucket name always should match the domain name, like nashtri.com bucket should match the domain name nashtri.com, and for subdomain also same. Also, we will give permission for the bucket to be give everyone get object permission to be the content of our website accessible for everybody. And already we did some of this steps in a previous lab when we create our lab, last lab, like we create bucket nashtri.com and we enable access, get object permission for this in this bucket, and we create a bucket policy and give a statically get object permission for this bucket. Also, last, we will create two DNS records for root domain, one for root domain called nashtri.com, and we will map it to bucket nashtri.com, and we'll create another DNS record, a record called www.nashtri.com, and this will be mapped to www.nashtri.com bucket. Let us to start in the lab. After I log into my account in Amazon Web Service, I will go to SDV service. Then already we from the previous lab we create nashtri.com bucket, and we give permission bucket, we create bucket policy, we create bucket policy to enable everyone to get object for this bucket. Now, and we enable also the host static website for this bucket. Now, what we should do, I will create another bucket for subdomain called www.nashtri.com www.nashtree.com for the subdomain, and it will be in Ireland region, and I will create. After I create this packet, I should to enable hosting static website, and also here I will enable redirection from www.nashtree.com to nashtree.com bucket. So I will go to nashtree.com bucket, then I will go to properties, then I will go to static website hosting, then I will enable redirect request. Here I will put the bucket name that will be redirect to. Here it will be nashtree.com. Then I will save. After we create the redirection, now all traffic coming to www.nashtree.com should be redirected to nashtree.com. Now I will upload my static website files to bucket, the root bucket nashtree.com. I'll go here, and this already uploaded before, but I will delete this file. Then I will upload theme. I downloaded a free theme for static host site. For static site, I downloaded from internet. I will upload it to this bucket. I'll open this my theme I download from internet, this static website theme. I will copy and add it to upload bucket page, upload page. Then I will upload this theme. I'll wait till upload finish. This maybe it will take some time to be uploaded according to your file size. After we upload finish, now if I went to this bucket, till now we didn't create DNS record for on Amazon Route 53 for this bucket. I will go to the bucket now. Then if I went to the name of the bucket that hosted website, if I open this, then my website with the new files that I uploaded, new theme, should be open. We will wait till this finish uploading, and we will test our website. As we told before, also we can put here error page for an error happen when you browse your when anybody browse your website to be routed to be redirected to this page. Now almost upload finish. Now the upload finish. After I upload, now if I open this link, then my website should be open with the new theme. Now the new theme, it's opened, the theme called Apollo, and this my new website uploaded to S3 and hosted on Amazon S3. Now after the website, it's the files uploaded, now I will still the my domain under Amazon AWS.com domain. Now I will create to be my own domain like nashtree.com only or www.nashtree.com. So I will go to S3, I will go to my services, then I will go to Route 53 service. Then from Route 53 service, I will go to hosted zone. I will go to the hosted zone that I created for nashtari.com, as we did in last lab in part one. Then I will create record set here. As we mentioned, we should to create two A records, one for the root domain, other one for the subdomain www, and we can create for any other subdomain. I will create record set. From here, I will select, it should be A record, and here the name will be for root domain, so this will be empty, and this will be alias and map to Amazon nashtari.com nashtari.com bucket. This Amazon S3 bucket. I will select this bucket Amazon nashtari.com. Then I will create the record. Now the record for nashtari.com, it's created. So if I go and write this domain, maybe this will take effect, need some time to take effect. Nashtari.com, should my website be opened? This will take, maybe need time to take effect. According to effect taken, I will go also, I will create another record set for www domain, subdomain called www.nashtari.com, and from here I will select the second bucket called www.nashtari.com. As you see before, when I put only nashtari.com and this empty, only show me here nashtari.com bucket without www, because as we mentioned before, the bucket name should match the domain name. Now I will select the www.nashtari.com, and I will create the record set for www here without dot, sorry, www.nashtari.com a record. Here we create a record. Now we have two domains, one nashtari.com and subdomain www.nashtari.com. We'll check if the effect's taken or no, not yet. Now look, my website, it's open under nashtari.com, my domain. Also, even if I open as www.nashtari.com, www.nashtari.com, then my website, the traffic will be redirected from www.nashtari.com bucket to nashtari.com bucket, and this my domain, my website will be under my own domain. Thank you, and if you have any question, you can ask. Otherwise, maybe any update will be added to this course. And thank you for joining us to this course, and see you in other courses.
Hi everybody again. In this lecture, we will speak about how to enable your website to load quickly using Amazon CloudFront service. Amazon CloudFront is a global content delivery network, CDN, service that can be used to deliver your entire website, including dynamic, static, streaming, and interactive content, using a global network of edge locations. Requests for your content are automatically routed to the nearest Amazon edge location, so content is delivered with the best possible performance. This enables your website to load quickly from anywhere and allow you to use secure connection to your website through HTTPS. Amazon CloudFront optimized to work with other Amazon web services like Amazon S3 and Amazon Elastic Cloud Compute. Suppose your static website hosted an S3 bucket located in Ireland region, and someone browse your website from Canada, then if you integrate Amazon CloudFront with your S3 bucket, this request instead of routed to your S3 bucket directly, it will be routed to closed Amazon Edge location on Canada that has a copy of site content, your site content. So the latency will be very low and your website will load quickly. Thank you and see you in the lab how to configure and integrate Amazon CloudFront with S3.
Hi everybody. In this lab, we will learn how to integrate Amazon CloudFront with S3 to load our website more quickly. CloudFront is organized into distributions. In this lab, we will create a distribution for our website. Then I will point it to my S3 bucket that has my static website content. Once that distribution up and running, I will go to Route 53 service and modify the alias records that I created on previous lab to be pointed to CloudFront distribution. I log into my account on Amazon Web Services, but before that, I will go to my website, nashtari.com, and I will check from where my content is served. So I will go right click and inspect, and if I use Google Chrome, then I will go to network and reload the page. If I press on nashtari.com or hero page and or hero picture, I will see it's served from Amazon S3 and nothing mentioned for CDN or CloudFront, Amazon CloudFront. Now I will go to configure the Amazon CloudFront. So I will go to AWS console and I click to services. Then under networking and content delivery, I will select CloudFront. Now, I need to create distribution for my website. So I will go to create distribution. Then there is two type of distribution. Web distribution, it's used for content like HTML, CSS, PHP, or graphics files. And it's used with S3 buckets or web servers. Also, there is RTMP distribution. This used with streaming media files to stream your videos. So I will select get. I will press on get started for web distribution. Under origin settings, there is origin domain name, refer to from which you want CloudFront to get original version of your objects and web contents. It could be S3 bucket or web server. Here, I will select S3 bucket if I don't have redirect rule configured with my S3 bucket. But for me, in previous lab, I enabled the redirection from hosting static website configuration, so I should to use endpoint URL for S3 bucket that has static hosting setup to ensure redirection work. So here I will not select my S3 bucket because I enable the redirection. I will go to S3 service. I will get the endpoint URL for my S3 bucket that has content of my static website. I will go to my bucket, nashtari.com, that has my content. Then I will go to properties, then static website hosting. I will find here the endpoint URL. I will copy this URL, then I will paste in CloudFront as origin name, domain name, then origin path. If you want CloudFront to request your content from directory in your Amazon S3 bucket, then you can put here your directory inside Amazon S3 bucket. Origin ID, here you can put a description for your origin. Here I not all the settings we will configure, all some only some of this settings. So I will, for viewer protocol policy, I will select HTTP and HTTPS, but later in another lecture we will enable access to our website through HTTPS, so we will change it to redirect from HTTP to HTTPS, but for now we will keep it as HTTP and HTTPS. Also allowed method HTTP methods, it we will select get and head only. Also then we can here enable the compress object automatically if we need as our requirement. Also we need, here we need to select the price class, like if we need our content to distribute to all edge location, we can select it will be best performance. We can select all edge location Amazon locations, or we can select only United States, Canada and Euro. For now I will select for best performance all edge locations, and we can put here alternative domain name. The CNAME here lets you use your own domain, for example www.example.com or example.com for links to your objects instead of using domain name that CloudFront assigned to your distribution, because when you create your distribution, Amazon CloudFront will assign domain under, it will be ID, then under CloudFront.net. If you need to be under your domain, you should to put your domain here. So for me, I need to be under my domain, so I will put my domain nashtari.com. Also, you can put many domains, like if I need to put also www.nashtari.com, I can put comma, then add www.nashtari.com here. Then here, default root objects. This object that you want CloudFront to return, for example, index.html when a viewer request point to website root URL. So here I will put index.html, and here if I need to enable IP version 6 or disable it as you wish, but if you enable IP version 6, you should to create record for IP version 6 and root 53. For me, I will disable and I will enable the distribution. Then we will go to create distribution. This will take little time, about 5 to 10 minutes to finish creation. Now, after the distribution is created, my content, it will be saved under this domain id.cloudfront.net. If I needed to be under my domain, I will go to root 53 and create alias records or modify if I already have. So I will go to services, then root 53. I will select my hosted zone. After that, I will go to select to already I can in the previous lab I create nashtari.com a record alias a record. and I map it to my S3 bucket, but now I need to point it to distribution that I created now. So I will delete and wait till this targets be loaded, and I will select my distribution. This the distribution that I now I created. I will select, then I will save my record set. After that, till this DNS record be updated and the cloud front also update, maybe it will take time. We'll try to load our website again. Website reloaded. If I went to nashtery.com, it will be saved from cloud front. Also, if I went to cloud front service and I get this URL, our website URL on cloud front, this URL, and paste in the browser, my website, it will be open. Even if I get any image like this image, it will be under assets. It will be image, this image saved from cloud front. Thank you and see you in next lab. We will configure how to allow the user to access to our website through HTTPS protocol. Everybody, in this lab we will enable access to our website through HTTPS protocol. But to do this, we should to create SSL certificate and attach it to our domain. In Amazon services, there is service called Certificate Manager and allow you to create a free SSL certificate. And this is the good thing in Amazon, because in other websites, this costs you money. So to create SSL certificate, I will go to services, then under security and identify compliance, I will go to Certificate Manager. For me, already I create certificate for my domain in Ireland region. But if you need to request certificate, go to request a certificate for your domain. Then write here your domain that you need to attach your certificate to it. For me, nashtery.com. And if you need to make wildcard certificate that to be a certificate valid for all subdomains, what you need to do, you can put star dot your domain. For me, I already create this certificate. Then request certificate. Then they will send email to your registered owner for each domain, and you will confirm this certificate. After you confirm, you will find it issued on Amazon Certificate Manager. After you issued your certificate, you will go back to CloudFront service. Then go to your distribution setting. In general, you edit, and here in SSL certificate, it's used default CloudFront certificate. You can use your certificate, custom SSL certificate, and select your certificate for your domain and save the change. Also, under behaviors, you can go to and edit the settings and redirect HTTP to HTTPS, or if you need, you can leave it HTTP and HTTPS, or only if you need, you can allow HTTPS access. Then save the settings. Now if I went back to my distribution, after the save, after I save my settings, the effects, it will take time. Now if I went to my website homepage and reload the homepage, it will be redirected from HTTP to HTTPS protocol. As you see here, now my website working under HTTPS, and any traffic coming also if was through HTTP, it will be redirected to HTTPS. Thank you.